Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Hear me when I call, O God of my righteousness. Thou hast enlarged me when I was in distress. Have mercy upon me and hear my prayer. O ye sons of men, how long will ye turn my glory into shame? How long will ye love vanity and seek after leisure? Selah. But now that the Lord has set apart that is godly for himself, the Lord will hear when I call unto him. Stand in awe and sin not. Commune with your own heart upon your bed and be still, Selah. Offer the sacrifices of righteousness and put the trust in the Lord. There be many that say, who will show us any good? Lord, lift thou up the light of thy countenance upon us. Thou hast put gladness in my heart more than in the time that their corn and their wine increase. I will both lay me down in peace and sleep, for thou, Lord, only makest me dwell in safety. I have read Psalms 4 in its entirety. May the Lord have a blessing on the readers and the doers of his holy word.
Amen. Come on, praise the Lord, everybody. Amen. Come on, let's give God praise.
The heavens, hallelujah, and his glory. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Above all nations. Hallelujah. Give God the highest praise. Come on, put those hands together. Hallelujah.
The Lord is high above the heavens.
Today, and if you'll never Yes, sir. lose power. When God raised Jesus from the dead and Jesus had one foot on ground, another foot in the grave, he declared that all power in heaven and in earth is in the palm of his hand. We thank you for those hands. Those hands that heal. Those hands that raise the dead. Those hands that spoke. Withered hands became straight. The woman with the issue of blood dried up. Peter's mother-in-law got up. Jairus' daughter got up. All because of the power that lies in your hand. That power, when we've fallen off, has put us back in place. That power that saved us has been blessing our lives, and keep that power that kept a roof over our head. That power that gave us strength to shower and bathe and get dressed. That strength that drove us to church, and you protected us and you kept your angels all around us. It's that power that we're in love with. It's that power. At the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. Lord, forgive us for our sins. Lord, purge us and wash us thoroughly. Cleanse us from our iniquity. Lord Jesus, please don't let this be done or taken unworthy. Lord, make us worthy to eat of your body and drink of your blood. You told us as often as we do this, we do show forth your death until you come again. God, we thank you for the ninth month, nine. I thank you, God, that I have made all nine. I thank you, God, that I'm in fellowship. I thank you, God, that we're in fellowship with you. We're not out of the ark of safety. We're in fellowship with you, God. We thank you for your sustaining, keeping power. Is our prayer. Amen. Jesus and his 12 disciples went in the upper room and break the bread. The Bible says he break it. He distributed it to the 12 disciples. The disciples wanted to have one last meal before Jesus was on his road to the crucifixion. He said, as often as you eat, you do show forth my death till I come again. Let's eat of this unleavened bread, which represents Jesus' broken body for us. Let us eat. He took the cup. So this represents the new covenant, my blood. This grape juice is symbolic of the blood and water that ran from the crowns that they placed on his head and crushed his head. There were 72 thorns in that thorn head.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Blood ran from his head. Lord. Not only did blood run from his head, but blood ran from his wrist, palms. They nailed him to a tree that was in the form of a cross. They nailed his feet, nailed his hands just in case he would try to fight back, nailed his feet just in case he would run. Then they did something else. They grabbed a knife or spear and they pierced him in his side. Notice, y'all, blood ran from his crown. Blood ran from his arms, his palms. Blood ran from his feet. But blood and water ran from his side.
Yes, yes.
Blood that saved us, water for the remission of sin.
Yes.
Let us never, ever eat of him and drink of him and not think about what he did for us to be here. I wouldn't serve a God that I couldn't serve. I wouldn't serve this God that could do anything but fail. I would not serve this God if he couldn't get up. Our God talks back to us. Our God is at the right hand side of his Father.
Thank you, God.
Let us eat of him and drink of him. All right. Thank you, Jesus. All right. I'm not going to hold y'all long because we have a big service at 3 o'clock. Thank you. All right. I'm going to give y'all time to go get a little sandwich. A little horse divers or something. Before church goes. Hors d'oeuvres. I'm ready to preach now. Amen. Shine on me. I'm old school sometimes, y'all.
Since I live.
15. Today is the day. You've been hearing me talk about it for 2 months. It's over. I'm so glad this time has come. It is over. Today is the day for the first annual Ecumenical Preach Hers Gospel Bowl.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
We're turning the ladies loose. You always see the men. But today, Pastor Elliot Ivey and Marty Peters are turning the ladies loose.
All right.
It's gonna be on everything. It's gonna be on everything. It's gonna be on all my pages. It's gonna be on Pastor Ivy page, Church of Restoration page, Church of Restoration, I think YouTube page is gonna be on. It's gonna be on Victory YouTube page. It's gonna be on all of our social media streams, IG, Facebook, Instagram, Martin Peters, Marty Peters, Real Talk, Marty Peters Ministries, Victory Bell. Hey! It's gonna be on everything.
Amen.
Now don't be cheap and watch and not sow into the ministry.
Amen.
Sow a seed in the word that you receive.
Amen.
Now like the watch, which I don't like the key. But I'll just be one of the first pastors to tell you the honest God truth. I'm not afraid. I'm not scared of y'all.
Amen.
I'm just keeps it real. That's why my show is called Real Talk, because he keeps it real. All right? And I keeps it real in the pulpit, all right? So we want you all, I want at least 3,000 people watching today. On all our social media streams. Y'all going to be out of church. The night service won't even start yet in the South and the Midwest. Y'all watch us, all right? Y'all in Atlanta, y'all in Mississippi, y'all in Texas. Y'all watch us. Y'all been telling me all week long, y'all gonna watch us. The order is Minister, Co-Pastor Yannick Peters will be first. Dr. Donna Allen will be number two. Reverend Erica Godfrey will be number three. Pastor Shanice Criswell will be number four. And Evangelist Jackie Milton will be five. Let me say also to the family of Pastor Jabari Cardo, we extend our heartfelt condolences to you in the loss of your pastor. He was only 43 years old. He was a friend of mine. We just did a funeral about 2 months ago, and we had a good time. But to his church and to Mama Carjo, we extend our gratitude on behalf of the Victory Baptist Church. We extend our condolences. We're praying for you all. We're praying for your family, that God will strengthen you all in your very weak moments of grief. Psalm 27. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked came against me to eat up my flesh, they stumbled and they fell. Though an host shall encamp against me, my heart shall not fear. The war shall rise against me. In this will I be confident. One thing I have desired of the Lord that I will seek, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in his temple. For in the time of trouble he shall hide me in his pavilion, in the secret place of his tabernacle. He shall hide me, he shall set me upon a high rock. You all may be seated in the presence of the Lord. The word of the Lord is already richly blessed. I want to talk about God got me.
Preacher.
Last week we started this sermon. Y'all know I preach series on this Psalm 27. It got good to me. I had to let it go. Talking about this Psalm 27, David is the psalmist, is the author of this text. And in this text, David acknowledges that he will prove that he has reassurance in the days to come of the trials and tribulation that he will have to face. He speaks in this Psalm 27 of past victories. He speaks of his faith for future victories. David knew that in his life, the only safe place to be was close to God. He says that in verse 4. David wanted to be in a place where he could see God, speak to God, and worship God. This was David's heart desire. There is a danger, y'all, being outside the will of God. Can I try one more time? There's a danger.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is.
Being outside the will of God. But David is informing his listening audience that God is where he needs to be.
Okay.
Last week, I gave you my first point. Let me just bump it a little bit today, hit it a little bit today, and go on to point two. Number one, In verse 5, David says that for in the time of trouble he shall hide you in, he shall hide him in this pavilion, in the secret place of his tabernacle, he shall hide you. He shall set me upon a high rock. David tells his audience that he has guaranteed guidance. When you have an authentic relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ, when you have a relationship with God, God is guaranteed to guide us. Hear this right here, y'all. If we let and if we allow God to guide us, if we allow God to give us direction in life, it makes no sense, ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, to be a Christian and not follow God. If you at work, you got to follow the guideline and the procedures of that company. You ain't at work doing it your way. And if you are at work doing it your way, it won't be too long. You'll be at work doing it your way. It's either their way or it's the highway. Come on, talk to me to somebody. David uses these personal pronouns when he says that he will hide me in his pavilion. He said in the secret place of his tabernacle, he'll hide me. Then he says he shall set me upon a high rock. This is all in verse 5, y'all. It's all in verse 5. I'll back up and get to the other verses in this series. Right here, y'all. He said there's two things going on right here. Number one, it's a personal activity. This is something God does on his own on the behalf of those that believe in God. You have some special protection. You have some secret service agents when you allow God to lead your life. Two things. It's a personal activity, but second, it's a passive activity, which the believer is required to do nothing but be in a close relationship with God. Now, I got to pause parenthetically here because somebody need to get this. It's too many Christians that are too busy for God. You can't say nothing because I'm talking to some of y'all. I wish I had somebody talking to me in here. You gotta learn how to be real. You gotta learn how. If you can take time out to spend 2 or 3 or 4 or 5 hours getting your hair done, if you can spend 1 or 2 hours getting your nails done, if you can spend hours on social media, if you can spend moments and minutes in traffic, y'all ain't talking to me. Then why you can't spend hours and moments and minutes with God? He's the source of our strength. He's the strength of our life. In him we live, we move, and we have our being. We're nothing without God. Let me put this in your spirit on the first Sunday of the ninth month in 2022. And that is, if you don't have no time for God, then you're too busy doing nothing. Because nothing is more important than your relationship with Jesus Christ. I said ain't nothing. You can go shopping all day. Some folk get the Black Friday on time, but never get the church on time. Shame on you. In lines for hours. Fighting over one 65-inch screen TV, and they only got one out there. You threatening to lose your life over nonsense. Ain't nobody talking back to me up in here. If you have no time for God, you're too busy. Because ain't nobody that busy. social media. Would y'all help me, please? Because I came by. Amen.
You're
here.
Preaching.
I'm your pastor. I would be less than your pastor if I didn't tell you the honest God truth. If you can't pray, if you can't read no scripture, if you ain't got time to be on Bible class all during the week, which only take about 5 hours, you're too busy. God understand that rigmarole and that lie you tell it. He understands you're full of manure. How you gonna hide something from God? And some of y'all think, you know, God ain't got a forgery. He ain't forgetting nothing.
Right. Not at all.
I can't even get no help in social media land because they feeling guilty being at home watching. I understand.
Amen.
I just didn't know this Psalm 27 was just going to work like this. I didn't know I was going to be cutting like this. Yeah, I hope I cut enough for you to change. All right. For Christ.
Okay.
That's 3 points.
Amen.
Here's the message, y'all. The Lord is intensely interested in what is happening in your life. But he wants you to tell him what's happening in your life.
Amen.
See, the Lord wants communication with his children. If folk know that you go to church and they never ask you to pray for them, they never ask you to look out for them or something like that, they may know that you ain't got no real relationship with God. They may just, you just go to church, just
they
go to church.
Wow.
Ooh.
They
may just be like, oh, well, okay. Hey, all right. Here's what it is. Never forget that the Lord is interested in what is going on in your life. He's ever present. His eyes are on every detail of our lives. Watch this, y'all. Hear this right here. This is where it gets difficult and a little hard. We may not understand the leadership of God, but trust the process.
Right.
I don't understand how God works. I really don't. I don't understand how God works. It's not mine to understand how God's work, because if I did understand how God worked, I still wouldn't understand how God works.
Right.
Wow.
Because to go to heaven, you gotta die. You gotta go down, then go up. I don't understand it.
It's a process.
You gotta pray for those that talk bad about you. I don't understand that. If they ask for your vest, they say give them your coat too. It's more blessed to give than it is to receive. Come on, y'all. Pray for those that despitefully use you and speak all. I don't understand the leadership of God, but I trust the leadership of God. And when you can't track them, or trace them, we must always still trust them no matter how hard it gets. He's guiding and guarding our footsteps.
Yeah, right.
Number two, I'm moving on. I told y'all I'm only going to be about 20 minutes. Hear this right here, y'all. Number one, we have what? Guaranteed guidance. Hear this right here. Number two, we have a God who guards.
Amen.
Number one, we have guaranteed guidance. But number two, we have a God who guards.
Thank you,
God. Hear this right here, y'all. Have you ever been on your way to seeing? Listen, don't y'all get, this is not the time in the message to get quiet. Because some of y'all are the CEO of the sin committee.
My God.
I used to be, I gave it a shot. We have a God, this is comedy, who guards.
Right.
David tells us that the Lord will hide him in the pavilion, in his pavilion, in his pavilion. Remember last week I told y'all couldn't say amen because you don't really know what the pavilion of God is?
Uh-huh.
I'm going to explain it today,
right,
and we're going to all go get some chicken. Here it is,
right,
baby. David tells us that the Lord will hide him in his pavilion. Watch this, y'all. A king's pavilion was a tent that erected in the middle of the army's encampment. The king's pavilion was a tent that was erected right in the middle of the army's encampment. The tent was surrounded by an army of brave soldiers with all of the hosts of the army camp about it. The king, this was the safest place on the battlefield for the king. Y'all
right in
the middle. The pavilion was a tent that was erected right in the middle of the army's encampment. The tent was surrounded by an army of brave soldiers that protected the encampment. With all of the people in the camp, that was the safest place for the king to be. Y'all gonna help me?
Yeah, preach.
If you were fortunate enough to be allowed in the king's pavilion, you were highly protected.
Right, amen.
Watch this. Ken, you may like this. Ken, our drummer, is a professional bodyguard. He guards some people that we like, some boxers that we like. He's large enough to be a bodyguard.
That's right.
He's large enough. Ken is 6'8" and smaller than me now. When he first got here, I think I hoped him out by exercise, and he just took it to another level. It's like Iron Man in the gym. But people pay Ken to protect their lives. When you're a child of God, you ain't got to pay nobody to protect your life, because the Lord, David tells us that the Lord will hide us in the secret of his pavilion. I just told y'all the pavilion for a king is right in the middle of the army's encampment, and that was the safest place for the king to feel safe. A host of army protected him. When you got God, you have a God that guards you.
Yes.
I wish I had somebody talking back to me. Watch this, y'all. The word hide means to treasure away. I used to be slow too. The word hide means to treasure away.
Okay.
My mama taught me so much in life. I remember, as I get older, it's just start coming back. I didn't kind of listen. Kind of, when I was younger.
Yeah.
I would have a lot of money in the bank right now if I just listened.
Right.
My mama said, Marty, you don't need to spend all of your paycheck. Just put like $25 away a week and just save and just watch it grow. I didn't listen. I needed all my money. I needed to waste all. My mama said, this is a saying, I don't know if you have a mama like my mama. That's just like going to the bridge and just throwing your money over.
Yeah.
I know what that is now.
Right.
Some stuff we spend money on, we really don't need it. You don't need a mama to tell you that. You can listen to your pastor tell you that.
Right.
Have you ever bought something you're like, oh my God, I don't even want this? Y'all being stingy with your amen. But hide means to treasure away.
Right, amen.
When you have valuables,
yes, Lord.
You can have a jury, a locked jury box. You don't place your valuables out in the open.
Right.
You ain't talking back to me. Now. Just because you got a lot of money in your pocket, you don't walk around with money hanging out your pocket. Jewelry and diamonds and bracelets and necklace, that don't just go sitting on top of your dresser. It should not be in the open for everybody to see. Come on, y'all. Treasure means, hide means to treasure away. So when you have a God that guards, he'll tuck you in the safety of his own jewelry box. You ain't talking. You hide your way so people can't get to you.
Right, amen. Thank you, God.
Amen.
Isn't it great to know that we are safely tucked away in the King's Pavilion?
Yes.
Thank you. Watch this, y'all. Colossians chapter 3 and verse 3 says, "For ye are dead, and your life is hid with Christ in God." We used to be dead, but the Lord redeemed us and brought us back. So now we're safe in his arms. Not only are we safe, but we're secure in his arms. Gotta give y'all one more S. I wouldn't be a preacher if I didn't give y'all another S. And we have salvation in the Lord. We're safe, we have salvation, and we are secured in God.
Yes. Amen.
Listen, if you are in his pavilion, you are protected by a camp of army. You ain't talking to me. What does that mean? I'm finished. No enemy can get to us because the pavilion is protected.
Yes. Thank you.
Amen.
Thank you,
God.
So when that drunk driver went around your car and hit the island and hit the car in front of you, you're protected in his pavilion. When COVID jumped over your house like the blood was on the doorpost, you ain't talking back to me. You're sad. I'm about to feel good in there. In his pavilion. When you didn't get cancer, when you didn't get a venereal disease, when you were living righteously and living like the prodigal son, nothing happened to you. It's because the Lord had you tucked in his pavilion and nobody could get to you. Preach, Marty. It's time that you stop living scared and live like you got some protection. If the Lord told you to go to school, go back to school. If the Lord told you to organize a business or start your business, start your business. If the Lord told you to get out of that relationship, get out of it before it costs you your life. Before it costs you your reputation, get out. Some stuff ain't worth dying for.
Amen.
Am I preaching to this somebody? If you're in the King's Pavilion, then you are protected in the King's Pavilion.
Oh, yes, thank you.
I'm glad I'm in the King's Pavilion.
Oh, yes,
thank God.
Some of the stuff I thought I need, I don't need.
All
right. Y'all done stop helping me.
Like
that. Huh?
Uh-huh.
Have you ever wanted a man and you just held a conversation with him and found out? You know, that was only good on the surface. Okay, sister, men over here, let me talk to you. Hopefully, shine for here. Listen, men, have you ever saw a young lady and she was all that from the outside, and then you met her, she wasn't none of that.
Yeah.
She never stopped talking. She the boss of everything. She want to be the man and the woman in the relationship. You wear pants, but she just want to tell you which ones to put out. The men will help me because these ladies aren't going to help me on that. Amari, you got me, kid. Shine, yeah. That be the Lord telling us that it's just some stuff you don't need. Because y'all, everything that look good to you ain't always good for you. y'all. I thank God for his protection.
Yeah.
I've been in some dangerous places. I've been around some dangerous people. Come on, y'all. I've been at funerals when they start shooting. But the Lord had me protected. Come on, y'all. I've been some places and I've seen accidents behind me, and I'm looking in my rearview mirror like, God, you protected me, and I'm going to move right through.
Thank you.
Amen.
Amen.
Woo.
Amen.
Don't by yourself.
Come on, y'all.
Yeah.
This is the place where you don't be quiet in the sun. Let me talk to a few of y'all in there. Can I talk about 6? I'll make number 7. Aren't you glad that God has guarded you and guided you and protected you from some people and some things and some enemies and some places? Because although God may be everywhere, but God ain't in everything. And I don't want to be nowhere where God is not. I'm a macho man, and I come from the hood, but there's some places I don't want to be that God ain't there.
Right.
Yes,
go.
Yeah.
Elsa. You better preach, bro.
Blessings. Blessings up. Nobody can get you.
Glory, glory.
Protect you from the enemy.
Right, amen.
It is right here, y'all. Yep, what time is it? I'm saying. Oh, they helping me on social media. Look at that. Y'all shout me, huh? I'm protected.
Right
here, y'all. Let me give you 3 things in our minds. Number one, we have a place to exchange our trouble for his peace.
Yeah.
Like this, my kid is right here. Number one, we have a place to exchange our trouble for his peace.
Yeah.
Y'all ain't feeling it. We have a place to exchange our trouble for peace.
All right. Amen.
Some of y'all can't shout right there and say amen because you will choose trouble over peace.
Oh.
Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I'll give you peace.
Amen.
Some of y'all like being laden down. Some people like it. Because you like that type of attention. See, when you've been delivered from the opinions of others, then you can start maturing and growing in the grace of God. But when you're still on the sideline waiting for the approval of people that don't like you, you'll never get approval. When you've been free from the opinions of people, then you can march forward and move forward and climb higher in your life. When you can be free from what people think and feel about you. Some of y'all can't grow because you're too scared of what they gonna say. I'm 53, y'all.
Come on, man.
I gives a care. Right.
Come on, man.
Right.
That's the nicest way I can say that this live.
Yeah. Right, amen.
I'm with you.
I give a care what people think and say about me.
Me neither.
I'm a Peters. People have been talking about us all our lives. And half of it is jealousy.
Right.
My mama is beautiful. My daddy is handsome. My sister is beautiful. Me and my brother, we are.
Oh,
Shine, you just
are. Wow. What's going on here?
Yeah, when I was younger, I would get mad.
Right.
Yeah, when I was younger, I would cuss you out from A to Z.
Me too, when I was younger.
And yet still be saved.
Me too.
I did that in my 20s. I did that in my 30s. I did that in my 40s. But y'all, I'll be doggone if I'm going to be held captive of an enemy that has nothing to offer me or do for me in my 50s. I don't know how much longer I got on earth, but I ain't going to be worried about the time that God has allowed and left for me to be crying and wondering and fighting a rumor and fighting a fly. You can fight one fly and it exhausts all your energy for you, and you won't have no strength to fight nothing else.
Get
him on the day, man.
Yeah.
You've been free. the opinions of others.
That's right. That's right.
You can move forward and progress. Pavilion is a place where we exchange our trouble for peace.
All right.
But not only that, y'all, in this pavilion is a place to find joy even during troublesome times.
Oh, yes. Thank you, Lord. Uh-huh.
When you can shout and you ain't got all the money.
Amen.
When you can praise God and you ain't got a clear doctor report. Slow everywhere. Y'all, I always say this, y'all, but y'all have witnessed in the last year and a half a true warrior. And that's my mama. Y'all seen her be bed stricken for 6 months, couldn't do nothing. Y'all ain't talking back to me there. And God healed her hip. And then in March, fall and break her ankle, got two pins in there, was in a wheelchair, was on a walker. Now mama walking there on a cane again. And even if mama had to hold on to the chair, mama was still giving glory. And I watch some of y'all, you ain't broke a hip, you ain't broke a bone, you ain't broke a toe, you ain't broke an ankle, you ain't got nothing. God been good to you, and you won't even lift your hands. You won't even shout amen. You won't even shout glory. If you want to know what a miracle is in 2022, there's Dolores Peters right there. You gotta know, you God gave you sustaining, bouncing back power.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, God.
You can find joy.
Hallelujah.
And you ain't got the car.
Hallelujah.
You can find joy and you ain't got the car, the house. If you can find joy in an application that you feel not winning on God. Bring it to pass.
Thank you, Jesus.
I gotta quit. I'm getting tired.
Thank you, Jesus.
Gotta save some energy to holler today for all the ladies that's gonna be preaching.
All right.
Find joy during troublesome times.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. But not only can you exchange your trouble for peace, not only we find joy in your troubles,
yes, sir.
But y'all, we got a promise.
Right.
He'll never leave us.
Yes.
He'll never leave us.
Yes.
Nor forsake us.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
It may get dark, but he'll never leave us.
Thank you, Jesus.
I've seen the lightning flash. I've had the thunder roll. I felt sin breakers dancing, trying to conquer my soul. But then I heard the voice of Jesus bidding me to fight on Helios. He promised.
Jesus.
Yes, he did.
Oh, yes, God.
Hallelujah.
Oh, promise.
Not believers.
Oh, he promised.
Here's the shouting point. If God made your promise last year, God made your promise 5 years ago.
It's still working.
God made your promise 5 days ago. God made you a promise 5 minutes ago in this sermon.
It's still working.
He'll never lie.
Thank you, Jesus.
You don't know when to shout.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
I said, God made you a promise.
Yes, he did.
Thank you.
He won't lie.
Thank you.
Then one of your daddy's greatest joys, and he's told me this, is he saw you get off drugs and turn your life around for God.
Thank you, Jesus.
I pray
that
the Lord allow me to make enough money so I can give my mom and daddy a check. I pray that God keep my mom and daddy alive long enough that I can take them on trips and put on a plane with me and take on a shot. I pray to God that God blesses me and God blesses this church and God elevates me in my life so I can do something to somebody else. If you're trying to be blessed and you're trying to hold it to yourself, you ain't about to be blessed. But if you're trying to help your church, if you're trying to help your friends, if you're trying to help your family, then you're gonna get ready. We got a promise.
Yeah.
Thank
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir,
Father. We got a promise.
Thank you, Jesus.
Got a promise.
Yes.
Yeah.
Only
doing,
only doing.
See, when God is guarding us,
yeah.
We have confidence and victory.
Oh, yes.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
I'm finished.
He promised.
Thank you,
Jesus.
That's enough.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you,
Jesus.
Thank
you,
Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for your word.
Thank you.
Thank you for your promise.
Yes, God.
Thank you.
Thank you for everything you've done for us.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you for your word. Thank you for guiding us and guarding us and protecting us. Thank you for your word.
You gave me so much more.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, God. You've been good to us.
You've
blessed us. We don't know what we would do without
you. Yes, God.
Be lost, Father. Be lost.
So, Father, would you please keep taking care of us?
Yes, God.
God, would you give us that Jabez prayer? Enlarge our territory. Keep the enemy away from us. Help us to be prosperous and blessed. It's in Jesus' name. Amen. If you never accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, very quickly, here it is right here. If thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in thine heart that God raised him from the dead, you shall be saved. John 3:16 says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. This is my prayer for you. I hope that you accept Jesus Christ as your personal Savior. All you got to do is believe he died, believe he rose, and wanted to accept him into your life. And the Lord will accept you. That is my prayer. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord cause his face to shine upon you. Right on the bottom of the screen, there is a number. If you want to be saved, or if you want to become a virtual member, or even a member of the Victory Baptist Church, it's right on the bottom side of the screen. Myself or Minister Yanni will get back to you within 24 hours. God bless you. God keep you. It is time to worship the Lord without giving, streaming, and in the building.
Amen.
It's time to worship the Lord, those of you streaming and in the building. Bless you all on social media. Thank you. Bless you all. Don't y'all forget to sign back on at 2:55. Our countdown will start. Worship will start at 3 p.m. promptly. Those of you watching, I know you're going to come on back and watch. I know you're going to come back on. There are giving mechanism right there at the bottom side, left-hand side of your screen is your giving mechanisms. There are safe giving mechanisms for the Victory Baptist Church. All right. We're going to sign off. We'll be back on in about an hour and 30 minutes for our countdown. Y'all come on back. Come on back. Come on back. Come on back. Like and share. All right. We'll see you. Bless you. Peace. See you again.
Hey everybody, and we thank you for joining in into the Victory Baptist Church worship today. We pray that you were blessed, and we pray that the Lord met your need in today's worship. Our prayer is that you will come back next Sunday at 12 p.m. and join us again for another wonderful, incredible service. Be blessed, and thank you for watching.